Hi, my name is Mason Flannery, and I'm a product manager with endress-hauser. Today, I have one of our new Promag W800 battery-powered electromagnetic flow meters that I'm going to unbox and show you the ease of installation and commissioning. So, if I go ahead and open up the paperwork, this will have all of the relevant information needed for this device, your safety documentation, your technical manuals, everything like that, as well as calibration certificates and other relevant information. This insert in the box comes out to make it easier to remove the meter. So I'm going to finish cutting away the plastic. All right. You have your antenna for your cellular communication. You have the Promag W800 flow meter itself. And then you have your batteries for your Promag meter. They ship separately. These are lithium batteries. So I'll start by opening up the meter so that we can set up the batteries, make sure everything is working properly. All right, once I have those screws off, the transmitter opens up like that, and you can see I've got a display. Basically, I can turn the meter on behind this display, and then got some power supply actions. My communication can be set up here. Your SIM card is located right here, and then cellular antenna connections there. So let's set that aside for a second. Go ahead and open up what comes in these battery boxes here. So if I open this up here, you can see here's one of the battery packages. And here's another battery package right here. This W800 Promag flow meter can be powered via external 24 volt power or the internal battery packs. So I'm going to show you how to install the battery packs here. It goes through, starting on page 27, how to install these battery packs. What I'll first do is open up this display housing, and then I'm gonna turn both of these set to off, since this meter ships without the batteries installed for the US requirements, shipping lithium batteries. I'm gonna turn that off before I go and do anything else. I'm gonna unplug the display as well as this ribbon cable right here to the main electronics. And then, using this Torx screwdriver, I'm gonna open up the battery compartment. Now that I've removed that battery compartment, you can see in here, there are two battery slots that you can install on this meter. So what I'm first going to do is install the buffer capacitor for this battery. So it goes right in this little channel here. Push that in, and then it plugs in right here. Then go ahead and install however many battery packs you have. I just have one, so I'm going to install it in this first battery slot and connect that to battery slot number one. We put our battery compartment back. Reconnect our ribbon cable and our display cable. Then I'm going to turn this back to on, and my meter should be powering up. So while I'm waiting on that, I'm going to go ahead and open up the antenna. You can see here the meter has powered on. So this antenna is to improve cellular signal and range. So that if your standard signal just coming out of the transmitter itself is not enough, this can extend the range and can be mounted you know, at a higher elevation or further away from the meter where you get a better signal. Comes with a couple components. So here's the main connecting cable for the antenna. Grounding plate, this is a polycarbonate housing, so to make sure that antenna is properly grounded. And then the antenna itself. So this antenna plugs in right here, this antenna slot. So I'm gonna plug it into antenna slot number one. And for now, I'm gonna just leave the antenna out. I'll hook up the grounding plate later when I actually go to install this meter. Hook up the antenna there. And this meter is ready to be installed. The Promag W800 has a touch to wake display, but all interaction with the meter is done using Bluetooth connectivity. So there is an app from endress-hauser called endress-hauser Smart Blue, which is used to connect to this meter. And then when your meter is powered on, you open the app, you should see that device show up. The last few digits of the serial number of that device. This one is T709-801-9000. Will pop up. So I will click that to connect to it. To connect to this meter, your default password, default username is admin, and the default password is the serial number of that device. So let me type that in. I go to the menu structure and I go to guidance. Do a guided commissioning of this meter. So once you're installed and ready to commission it, you can walk through this process. So I'm gonna say this meter's in Houston. This is gonna be a Houston demo meter. Hit next, we're gonna read in gallons per minute. We wanna read volume flow and to turn empty pipe detection on. So this meter should start telling me that I have an empty pipe. For setting the date and time on the meter, it has a real-time clock in it. I'm just going to have it take over that date and time from my mobile device here. So it saves that, which will automatically pick the time zone, and then set up the device for use. The other thing I want to do is I want to set the geolocation of this device. So I'll go to the menu, system, geolocation, and then take over the data from the mobile device. So I'm going to give it a moment to do that. And it now has the exact location where this meter's installed at our office in Houston, Texas. Next thing I want to do is check the cellular network connection. So I go to settings, system, connectivity, cellular radio network, and information. The display of this Promag meter has a touchscreen. That touchscreen is used to wake it up and show measured values. Normally it's not on, but all of your commissioning setup and interaction of the meter is done using Bluetooth connectivity. You can use a smartphone or tablet, connect to it using the endress-hauser Smart Blue app, which is available on the iOS store or the Google Play and Android store. All of your commissioning is done that way. If you're using a laptop computer, you would need the device care software. The display stays off in normal operation to retain battery. So let's close up the housing here. The Promag W800 electromagnetic flow meter is available in line sizes from 1-inch diameter up to 36-inch diameter. Also has this advanced transmitter for cellular communication, or if you're just using Modbus or a pulse totalizer output, it has a standard version that's a little more compact. All of the same benefits of the electromagnetic flow meters are available on the Promag W800. Different liner options, flanges, conductivity measurement, and much more. It also has the option for an integrated pressure transmitter mounted directly to the transmitter. It also helps for leak detection in remote pipeline systems. If you want to learn more about the Promag W800, contact your local endress-hauser representative or visit us at us.endress.com.